Hi guys, I'm back with a new video, and this video is another one in the series POTC, Path of the Crone. That's an initiative of my friend Heather, and her YouTube channel is called Ghost Queen Oracle. She has more YouTube channels, but that's my favorite one. And I'm going to talk to you about something that she hasn't talked to you about yet, maybe in the future. But I thought I would do this video, and the subject is menopause. In Dutch it's pronounced menopauze, and in English it's, I think, menopause. Now the pronunciation of the word menopause isn't the biggest problem. The biggest problem is the 30 plus life-changing effect on the life of a woman when menopause hits, and it hits hard. Now there is something called gray hair, and I turned gray as from age 24, not completely, but hair here and another hair there and a string here. And some men and some women have this beautiful, lush, shiny gray hair, and it's all natural, not handled by a hairdresser or whatever. It's just, you know, beautiful. In my case, it's a mess, and that's how I started to use these things. If you're a woman, you probably know what it is, and it has all kinds of interesting professional performance, oleo intense, permanent oil color, double oil booster. You know, it's just something to get rid of the gray hair. For me, so Sios is my favorite, so gray hair. Then I got my memory loss. I am already blessed. I have been blessed my whole life with memory loss and the gift to forget. And ever since menopause started to roll into my life, there was one senior moment after another, and that's another reason why I am doing these YouTube videos, because just in case I forget something, you guys can remind me that I already did a video about something like that, or I can look through my own list and check what the fuck did I say about this or that or whatever. Now it often starts with an increase of libido. You get more interested in sex and hormones, you know? It's the same with girls and boys in puberty, when they start in their teens and become youngsters, and hormones. And after a while, it's sort of, and especially for me being asexual, being aroused all the time was annoying, because I just choose to not do something about it. I prefer to ignore it completely. But it was quite hard. So now it's all down the drain, out of the window, and it's almost back to zero, which I like. So that's a good thing. Then I started to have irregular periods at the age of 30, 32, 33, and sometimes it was like a waterfall of blood, and sometimes it was just spotting, and sometimes I had cramps but nothing happened. And then all of a sudden, you know, I sort of was floating out of my bed because of very stressful and very annoying, and I found myself carrying tampons and towels all the time, just in case something would happen. Same as for girls in puberty, and it's still a little bit, you know, up and down. Sometimes it's there, sometimes not. Sometimes you cramp up and headaches and crying, and so that's a thing. Vaginal dryness, and breast soreness. Sometimes I find myself in the shower and I'm lost, like, I'm shaking these things and I was like, and I'm like, what's going on? What's happening, you know? And I have to cover myself because I can't stand water just, you know? Another thing is that I have always been a messy eater. There's always, I'm surrounded by crusts and crumbles and tomato ketchup and a pineapple and a slice of apple. And when I'm done eating, then I clean everything up and everything's fine. And it would just sort of fall out of my mouth and on my shirt. And, you know, no problem. But these days I have something, you know, because I used to have almost nothing except when I was pregnant and right after I gave birth. But these days I'm like, what's going on? The good thing about me being a messy eater and having something, what's that called? This gap. I don't know. It all sort of falls down in this, you know? So after I'm done eating, I can take out all the chocolate sprinkles and pieces of onion and pizza and spaghetti and taco. And so the good thing is I have something to, you know? So that's a thing besides them being very sensitive and sometimes even painful. It's, you know, sort of a safety net to drop all my spoiled food in. Mood swings and phases where you are extremely happy and then periods where you are extremely sad. And I went to see my doctor and he said birth control. And I was like, I am not in the mood to start a new family, so birth control. And he was like, it helps you regulate your periods again, and it also has a soothing, calming effect on your mood swings. So I started taking birth control pills and voila. A while back I was like, oh, I'm out. I have to go to the pharmacy and get new ones, and I forgot. And then a week after I thought, oh, I have to, and I forgot again. And I got sad and teary-eyed and depressed and moody. And then I was like, I think it's because I haven't taken these pills for, I think, 5 or 6 weeks now. And as soon as I started taking these birth control pills, my mood swings disappeared. So I don't care if I have to swallow whole packages the rest of my life, but it's a great thing to stay happy and healthy and balanced, and because else you are going sort of on a slide downhill into a weird tornado of emotions, and it's all hormones and chemistry and whatever. It's not something, you know. So I don't mind about that. Sleeping disorder. I have had a sleeping disorder all my life. I always needed a lot of sleep. And I always begged my parents on Friday night, can I please go to bed, please? I'm so tired. And they always was like, it's 10 o'clock. We can watch a movie. We can play a game. We can sit at a fireplace and tell stories. And also, I want to go to bed. I'm so tired. And once I was in bed, I couldn't sleep. And I was laying there. So sleeping disorder and sleeping problems and issues with falling asleep, no problem. Had them all my life. But ever since menopause rolled into my life, it became sort of, you know, an issue. But sleepless nights. When I got Chica, I got used to a sort of rhythm that helped me. Waking up at 4:30, walking the dog at 5 a.m., then take a little bit of a nap, and then start the day. That's, for me, something that helps me deal with the whole insomnia, not being able to fall asleep thing. What was I? Concentration. No concentration whatsoever. Even being a little bit of an ADD, ADHD type of girl, I noticed that making videos has become harder because I have to take notes more often. When I started 6 years ago, I was able to just take the camera, start, do a video, upload it, that's that. These days, if I have a subject in mind, I have to take notes because I can't concentrate on the whole story that I want to tell you. So that's the thing. And body odor, it's also, again, something that has to do with hormones. And I started using this odorem. That's a French perfume. It's very summery and flowery and summer flowers, fresh air, you know? It's beautiful and soft, and I like expensive perfumes when I use them. I don't use them that often, but at some point, I think at age 37, the perfume that I have been using for years in a row just didn't, I don't know, it just didn't work anymore. Now, if you are into perfumes, you know that a perfume is a perfume, it has a scent, but then it starts to interact with your skin and it creates a chemical relationship between what's in and on your skin and in your body and the scent itself, and then something different pops up than what's in the bottle because it's an interaction between you and the perfume. Then I was disappointed, you know. I expected myself to use this one for years till I was, let's say, 96 or something, but I was forced to look for something else, and that was L'Heure Bleue, the Blue Hour. And this is more spicy. This is wood, spices, and it's almost a male thing. Now, what the weird thing is that my skin and a scent, when they come together, it works best if I have a male type of, this is a deodorant. You have to use it under the shower. And I just bought a new one. This is all about, I don't know. It's fresh and it's spicy and it's, this has wood in it or something. Cedar or something like that. Which is great. So all the hormones that were coming in and coming out and swirling around and inside of me. My heart, irregular heartbeat. Normally it goes like boom, 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 and then it boom. I have no idea what that's about, but it seems to be one of the effects of menopause, and it's very. In the beginning, it made me nervous and anxious, and I was starting to hyperventilate a little bit because, you know, your heart, you know, you need your heart. You need this thing there beating, and it has to work. And when it doesn't, it made me freak out. Being irritated or annoyed too quickly, again, for me, it fits into the category mood swings and emotions and raging, and so the whole birth control thing solved that. Hot flushes. Seriously. My husband checked at some point because I was like, I feel a hot flare coming up. And he was taking my temperature with one of these pistols with a red light, and then you can point it on. And within 2 minutes, my temperature, body temperature, rose 3.5 degrees Celsius. And then after 10 minutes, it slowly faded and dropped. But that's a lot, and that's quick. And do not underestimate hot flashes. Night sweats, that's another thing. Night sweats. I thought that I was having a fever, or I was sick, or that I had some kind of infection. So I went to the doctor, and he couldn't find any infection, blood test done, and nothing. So I was taking pain medication because I thought I was sick and had a fever all the time, every time, ongoing, non-stop. Turned out night sweats belongs to menopause, and I took these aspirins and pain medication for completely nothing. I should have googled the whole list of effects of menopause, and then I would have recognized it. But in this case, my research abilities are still, you know, not really up to date. And night sweats, no fever, not sick, nothing, no infections whatsoever, night sweats. Then the headaches started. So I was like, okay, I took the pain medication for the night sweats, which is insane, and now I'm having headaches. Should I take pain medication or whatever? Your whole body and your whole mind and your whole emotions and your hormones are playing tricks on you like crazy, and you just don't know what you feel anymore. And if you feel something, you don't know what to think of it and what to make of it, and you know? So then the migraines started. Headache is bad, but migraines are paralyzing. I used EFT, tapping, to get rid of the migraines, which worked. They haven't shown up now for, I think, 6-7 months, and I am so grateful, because hot flares are awful. Night sweats, I can live with night sweats, but hot flares and migraines are, I think, the worst things in menopause. I'm not sure if these are the worst things. Maybe, well, there aren't any good things. Everything is bad. Really, everything is bad. But gray hair, memory loss. First, an increase of libido, then a loss of libido. Vaginal dryness, breast soreness and pain. Mood swings, depression, anxiety, sleeping disorder, insomnia, concentration issues, body odor, irregular heartbeat, irritability, hot flushes, night sweats, headaches, migraines. And then finally I got joint pains in my hands. You know, I sometimes put tape around it, and that's takes away the pain. I don't want to take too much painkillers or whatever. About the night sweats, I have found something that works for me. You have all kinds of these things. Imea Silhouette, that sort of makes you believe that it helps you with your weight, which it doesn't. It supports with menopause, hot flares, night sweats and mood swings. No more hot flares. Almost no hot flares. No night sweats. So, what's next after joint pain? Tingling extremities, muscle tension, electric shock sensation. If I had a busy day running around, working in the garden, helping clients, my legs sort of, it's like my legs turn into Star Wars laser swords, and you know, electricity, you know, tension and cramps, and and it's bad. That also adds to my sleeping thing. Digestive problems. Bloating. Sometimes I look like I'm pregnant, and I'm not going to show it to you, but sometimes I look like I am pregnant, and that also freaks me out, because I became pregnant a couple of times in a row without by the wind or something, and if I'm bloated, I freak out. I have a panic attack. So I went to the doctor and he checked. He made an echo, x-ray thing, and he saw eggs, and I was like, I don't want my egg, please. So even though my whole period menstruation thing stopped, I still have eggs and I can become pregnant. Then we have bloating, allergies. I always had some allergies to cats and some flowers like lilies, and but lately I am allergic to egg white. I can eat the egg yolk, but not the egg white. I am allergic to all the cats. I am allergic to, I don't know what I'm not allergic to, but especially things like cabbage and fruit, even strawberries and citrus. And I can have these in small amounts, but please do not give me a banana and a pineapple and a citrus like an orange and a bowl of strawberries. What I still can eat is blueberries, which is great, and grapes. So that's a good thing. Weight gain. This doesn't help with losing weight or getting your weight under control at all. It does help with the night flares and the night sweats and the hot flares, but fatigue and being tired is also a thing. And when I had my kids in diapers, I turned to something like this. These are stackers, and these really help in, I don't drink too much coffee, and these really help in giving me a boost. And when the kids grew older, I forgot all about them. But lately I am like, well, I can use a little bit more energy than I have now. These do not help with losing weight. They only give you a little bit more energy to do the things that you want to do and need to do. Fatigue, hair loss, shedding and thinning. I used to have hair, but these days I am not sure what's going on, but it's thinner. It's like it's still the same amount, but it's thinner, and my curls disappeared. I don't know where my curls went. I used to have curls, gone. Also something with hormones. Brittle nails, that was something that I noticed 3 years ago, and again I use tapping. And most of my nails are back to normal again, except for this one. And I had to give up my nail polish addiction. And I don't like fake nails. I like my real nails. They are quite strong and hard, and I like the shape. But I, because they were so brittle and they damaged, and you can't really work with nail polished and damaged nails. So I was crying my eyes out, because and now my finally after 3 years my nails are almost back to normal, and I was looking into my nail polish collection and most of it dried up completely, which is sad. And maybe I'm too old for nail polish, I don't know. Still have to make a decision about that. A burning tongue. At some point, I was working with angels and I was looking at a sigil, and it was supposed to help you overcome an addiction. And I felt my tongue burning. It started to burn. I couldn't smoke for Quite a while. And I was so, I don't know, I was like, angels, please, you know, angels, come on. I was more like, can you please help me forget smoking? So I just forget to smoke and then overcome my addiction and don't set my tongue on fire because that hurts. And I never touched the angel book again. But then I thought maybe it was just a menopause type of issue. Gum problems. I don't have problems with that. I can deal with that also using tapping. And then is a loss of bone density, which I also try to prevent with tapping EFT. About the tingling extremities, muscle tension, electric shock sensations. I have them in my, at night when I did a lot of cooking and gardening and doing healings and I used my arms a lot, then I have a little bit of an itchy skin and electric sensations, but mostly it's in my leg. And I bought something Chinese, which is based on ginger, and it says or something. I don't know. It says here, I probably pronounced it wrong again because my Chinese never existed. Another thing that I noticed is that my skin turned thinner and the creams that I used to use don't work with my skin anymore. It just gives me a rash. And then I found this Hydra Genius Aloe Water. L'Oreal. It's watery, it's more a gel type of thing than it's a cream. So now I started using this in combination with this perfume and that works. And this on my legs. And I'm hoping that since it's all started with gray hair and I was 24, I'm turning 49 in a couple of months, that I think I have everything on the list. And since I have already everything on the list, I hope that, you know, it's not fair. Life isn't fair. Life sucks. It's hell. See you next time. Bye.